Today, I'm going to deliver lecture on real analysis lecture 10 on sequence. Up to 10, 9 lectures, so already we have discussed about the basics of real analysis. What is function, what is sequence, what is the boundedness, what is set, focus, set, intervals. So all this already we learn about there. Okay. Now, I am going to discuss here about the sequence. Here I am going to discuss that what is sequence. Today class I am discussing what is sequence, example of sequence, range of sequence, and boundedness of sequence. And I want to also find that if I give any terms, I will give sequence. These topics today I am going to discuss, right? What is sequence? Right? What is sequence? This is real analysis unit 1, lecture 1. So, and like that, what is sequence? Sequence, let S be a non-empty subset of R. A function S into R, a function S to L to S is called sequence. Otherwise, you can say that a function S N to R is also called a sequence, or sequence or real sequence. Okay, I am defining two ways. So, first of all, let S be a non-empty subset of R. A function S N to S is called a sequence. Second one is a function S N to R is called sequence. If so, or you can say that it is a real sequence, right? We know about the function, right? We know about the function. Already we discussed sort of in two lectures about the functions. Now, same function, but my domain is different. My domain is N. There, I took that. My domain is N. There, I am doing any domain. So, out of N domain, I am taking here N. I am taking here N. So, the sequence, notation of sequence, it is denoted by, the sequence is denoted by Sn, this flower bracket Sn, or simple bracket Sn, or Sn. This open bracket Sn, flower bracket Sn, this symbol, right? But then Sn, alright, you can write this symbol out. Okay, this bracket, okay, diamond bracket, open bracket, flower bracket. The sequence we may denote by these symbols. If I write anything, you get that it is a sequence. Here for N belonging to N. My N is belonging to N. So if N equal to 1 to infinity, be sequence, then. So this is my sequence. Here, if I write N equal to 1 to infinity, or you can know that, that means my terms of sequence it is N equal to 1 to infinity only. Though the sequence then S1, S2, S3, dash, Sn are called, this is first term, this is second term, third term, and term of sequence Sn. Okay. So here, this term S1, S2, S3, dash, Sn are the first term, second term, third term of the nth term of the sequence Sn. Note here, I am taking that N equal to 1 to infinity, that equal to, you may write this Sn, you may write this Sn, this Sn, okay, that equal to S1, S2, so these are all sequences. We may write this like N equal to 1 to infinity, Sn, Sn, this Sn, okay, the sequence, right, all these Sn, these are all are the sequence. Example, I am taking that example, Sn equal to 1 by N, okay, Sn equal to 1 by N. Sn equal to n, here these are sequence. Okay, this is another one sequence, this is another sequence, right? What are the terms of sequence? If I substitute equal 1, 1, 2, 3. If I take Sn equal to 1 by n, the sequence Sn equal to what happened? 1 by n equal to 1, 1 by 2, 1 by 3, derivatives. These are the terms of the sequence Sn. Example, I take other thing. Sn equal to n square, then equal to what happened? Xn, the Dalton sequence, what happened? Xn equal to n square, that equal to 1, 4, 9, 16, 25. That means, so, I want to substitute n equal to 1 here. 1, if substitute n equal to 2 here, 4. If I substitute n equal to 3 here, 9. If I substitute n equal to 4 here, 16. If I substitute n equal to 5, 25, like this, we will get. Other example, Xn equal to n square plus 1. Sn equal to n square plus 1, that equal to 2, 5, n equal to 1 is up to 2, n equal to 2 square plus 1 equal to 5, n equal to 3, 3 square plus 1 equal to 9, 10. So like that, these are the terms of the sequence. If I take x is equal to 1 by n plus 2, so that equal to Sn equal to 1 by n plus 2, that equal to 1 by 3, 1 by 4, 1 by 5, 1 by 6. Example, Sn equal to n by n plus 1. If I substitute n equal to 1, so this is, if I Sn equal to this, so the sequence is this. Term of sequence are 1 by 2, 2 by 3, 3 by 4, 4 by 6. Sn, n square plus 1, plus n plus 1. Sn equal to what happened? N square plus n plus 1. So 3, 7, 13, yeah, yeah, yes. Sn equal to n square minus 1, n square plus 1. If I substitute n equal to 1, then what happens? N square minus 1, n square plus 1, 0, yes. So these are the terms of sequences. Okay. If I take Sn equal to n by 2n square plus 1, then what happens here? N by 2n square minus plus 1. Okay, here minus 1, right? Good. Here minus 1, you can take that, minus 1. 1, n equal to substitute 1, we will get here 2 minus 1 equal to 1. If I substitute n equal to 2, then what happens? 8 minus 1 equals 7, like this will get terms. Sn equal to 2 power and the sequence Sn equal to what happened? 2, 2 square, 2 cube, that is yes. Example, Sn equal to 1 by 2n, Sn equal to what happened here? Substitute n equal to 1, 1 by 2, n equal to 2, 1 by 2 square. Sorry, 2 power n, right? This is 2 power n. N equal to 3, then 1 by 2 cube. So these are the terms of the sequence, right? So these are the other examples of sequences, so which are written in my class. So these are the other examples of student and sequence. So these are the example of the my students in the class. So these are the examples. So you may write in place of anything. These are the examples of the. Okay. Can quickly read it. I will say that these are the examples of the sequences of my students. So, right. I want to give that what are the, which are non-example of sequences, right? Non-example of the sequences, okay. So, for that, I want to take that here I am taking that non-example sequence. What are the example of sequence? Examples of sequence already we discussed, no? Non-example of sequence, right? What is function first of all? So first of all, I am going to discuss that function. Okay. Here I am taking that A, B, okay. A comma B are two non-sets. If A to B is set to B function, if for every x belonging to for every x in A, there exists unique. There is unique y in B such that, okay, f of x so equal to y. So this is the function. So I am taking that a comma b are two non-empty sets. If a to b is set to be function, if for every x belongs to a, there exists a unique y belongs to b such that f of x equal to y. So this is the function, right? So here my sequence is function. That's why what can I take here? I would like to take that. This is my n natural number set. So 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm taking this is all S. Here 1, 2, 3, 4. There. S is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm taking S is n equal to natural number. If I take that this image, what is the function possibility? I am taking that 1, all element goes to 1, 2 goes to 1, 3 goes to 4 goes to 4. So next, this all element goes to 3. Okay. Any other one of this element goes to 4. So rest of all these elements goes to 4. Okay, rest of all elements goes to 4. If I like this, if I okay, the other way you can define that, other way also. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4. So that means, so if all element goes to 1 only. So this element goes to only 1. This is n. This is my map f. So like this how do you define? That means for every element in this set, there exists at least one image. There is such that there is any y belongs to that f of x is equal to y. For every element in n, there exists a unique y in S such that f of x is equal to y. This is a function. So this function I am defining as, how I am defining here Sn, right? This Sn. Now I am going to define that which are not functions, right? So this is my map. So I am taking that, what are the elements of 1? 2, 3, 4, I define that 1, 2, 3, this I take zero real line, this is natural number. I would like to define a sequence, right? I would like to define a sequence. So 2 goes to 2, 3 goes to 3, 4 goes to 4, and 5 goes to 5, like this. But 1 does not have any preimage. 1 does not have any preimage. So if I take this image, if I define like this, there is no image for 1, that's why it is not a sequence. Okay. Similarly, I would like to define other way also. So I am defining here 0, 1, 1 by 2, 1 by 3, like that. This is the real line, this is natural number n. So 1 doesn't have image, so if I have to 2, 2 goes to 1, 3, 3 goes to 1 by 2. 4 goes to 1 by 3, like this. So this is also not for sequence. This is why, because not, that means 1 does not have any preimage. So examples of sequence already we discussed. What are the examples of sequence? So let's see n. Okay. N square. 1 by n, 1 by 2n, or 2 power of n. So this kind of example already we discussed just now. Here I would like to take that non-example of sequence. I want to define this Sn is equal to my sequence. I will define that the sequence, the function. Here my function is Sn. Yes. A function Sn to R is a sequence. So Sn equal to, how I am defining here? Sn equal to 1 by n minus 1. So this is not sequence. Why? Because if I substitute n equal to 1, what happens? N equal to 1. 1 minus 1, that equal to 1 by 0, that equal to infinite. So, which means 1 does not have any pre-image. In the set, 1 does not have any pre-image, image in this set. So, that's why it is not a function. It is not a function, therefore, it is also not a sequence. Instead of this, you can take that 2n, you may take that n minus 2 also. It is also not a function. Okay. So, n minus 3 is also not a function. If you take that n square, like that also, you take that n square minus 5n. Plus 6. If I define this also, this is not sequence. Why? Because here 2, 3, you can substitute here 2, then what happens? 2 square 4, 4 plus 6 is 10, 10 minus 0, 3 plus 3, 9, 50 plus 6. So, this is not also sequence, right? If I substitute value, that means it will be getting some pre-image. Then only we say that it is sequence. Why? We will not function, so that's why it is not sequence. These are the non-example of sequence. You can say infinite non-example of sequence. So, what other time discuss only? Example of sequence. You can rewrite that. Okay. What is constant sequence? A sequence Sn is said to be constant sequence if it is defined by Sn equal to 0. A sequence Sn is defined by Sn equal to C, where C is real number, is called constant sequence. Okay, a sequence and not depend other also. A sequence Sn n to R is said to be constant sequence if Sn equal to C for all C belongs to, for where C is the real number and for all n belongs to 10. So then only say that it is called constant sequence. So that means okay, this is my n, all n goes to c only. Sn equal to c, if I n equal to 1, c, n equal to 2, c, n equal to 3, c, that means all other terms are c, c, c only. That's why it is a sequence. It is a sequence, and it is constant to sequence. Here, all terms goes to only C only. Just now already I discussed in terms sequence. Oh, this is 1, 2, 3. If I take that C in place of Sn equal to C, I am taking that Sn equal to C, that means C is any real number. In place of C, I am writing 1 is constant sequence, 2 is constant sequence, 3 is constant sequence, 4 is constant sequence. If I write any real number, E is a constant sequence, root 5 is constant sequence, root 10 singular. 10 is constant sequence, 5 is constant sequence. 1079, 15, root 39, you can take any number 1 by 2, 1 by 3 are all constant sequence. So, if I define any single real number, right? Problem. So, find the nth term of the sequence. So, 1, minus 4, 9, minus 16, 25, minus 36. And 6, 3, 5, 7, 1, minus 1, 1, minus 1, 1, minus 1, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, and 1. I have given here these problems. By using these terms, we have to find nth term. How do we define this? Okay, how do we define this? Okay, first of all, you can observe here 1 minus 4 9 minus 16. Okay, these type of problems will appear in examination, entrance examination. So be careful. Okay, I would like to find that this problem 1 minus 4 9 minus 16 25 minus 6. Right? So I want to find that 1 minus 4 9 minus 16 25, so minus 36. So question, this is question, find nth term from this. So answer is what is nth term for this case, right? Now you have to observe here how it is look like. Okay, first of all, you can think about the what are the terms, how it is look like. 1, 4, 16, 25, 36. For whatever positive and negative, here you can think that 1, 4, 9, 16, 25. How these terms is of the form. If I observe quickly here, so this is 1 square, this is 2 square, this is 9 square, no, sorry, 3 square, this is 4 square, this is 5 square, this is 6 square. So dash dash dash. These are the answer. But here we have minus, right? Minus sign. Minus. Here we have minus. Here we have minus. Okay. If parallel minus 1, minus a. So how it is look like? It is the form n square. It is the form n square. So simply get 1. Substitute 1 square. If I substitute 2, 2 square. If I substitute 3, 3 square, 4, 4 square, 5 square, 6 square. But the problem is here minus. The problem is here minus. First term is positive, second term is negative. How, what can I substitute here? So if we get n equal 1, you will get all positive, but I want to get negative numbers also, right? So for that, we have to think that. So this nth term of sequence is n square, okay. So here I want to get 1, right? So for that, what I am doing here now, minus 1 whole power of n plus 1, or you can write n minus 1 also. If I substitute n equal to here, n equal to, n equal to 1, then what happen? Minus 1 whole square, that equal to plus n equal to 1, 1 square. It will get 1. N equal to what happen? Minus 1 whole cube, that nothing but minus 1. So 2 nothing but 2 square. If substitute n equal to 3, what happen? Minus 1 whole, 3 plus 1 equal to 4, that is positive. And 3 square equal to 9. If substitute n equal to 4, what happen? Minus 1 whole power n plus 1 equal to 5, minus 5, and minus 1 whole power minus 5 equal to minus 1. 5 whole square equal to, sorry, 4 whole square equal to 16. So this is the nth term of the given n terms. So like that, we have to find all other things also. Find the entire sequence like this: 1 minus 4 minus 9 minus 16 25, right? So I am taking here 1 minus 4 9 minus 16 25, that equal less than equal minus 1 power n plus 1 n square. So if I put n equal to 1, these are the nth term of sequence. So here 6, 3, 5, 7, 9. What is the nth term of sequence for this? Okay. This is 1. But because of, okay, here 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. Oh, for by time here 1. The question is here 1. So 1, 3, 5, 7. That equal to n minus 1. N equal to half to 1. Then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Like this, you'll get 1, 3, 5, 7. That means Sn nth term is equal to n minus 1. Where 2, 4, 6, 8. How it look like here? 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. Which nothing but 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. Nothing but 2n. 4n. That means 2, yeah, n equal to after 2. N equal to 2 will get 4. N equal to 3 will get 6. N equal to 8 will get. N equal to 4 will get 8. N equal to 5 will get 10. So these are the Sn, right? The sequence of is like this 2, 4, 6, 8. And the sequence is 2n. The sequence is like this. If I take 1, 2, 1 by 2, 1 by 4, 1 by 8, 1 by 6. What is the nth term sequence? So, here repeat here 2, 4, 8, 16. So it is 2 for 1, 2 square, 2 cube, 2 power. That means nth term is 1 by 2 power n. Therefore, Sn is equal to 1 by 2 power n. That equal to 1 by 2, comma 1 by 4, comma 1 by 8, comma 1 by 6. That is the nth term sequence. So, here I am writing minus 4, minus 1. 4, okay, and 11, 20. See here, I will like to find the term. Well, how it is look like here? N equal to minus 4, right? So, minus 4, if I substitute Sn equal, if I take n square minus 5, if I substitute n equal to 1, 1 square minus 4. Minus 5 equal to minus 4. First one is over. If I substitute n equal to 4, minus 5 equal to minus 1. If I substitute n equal to 3, 8, 9 minus 5 equal to 4. If I substitute n equal to 4, 16 minus 5 equal to 11. N equal to 5, 25 minus 5 equal to 20. So, the nth term of this sequence, right? Nth term of this sequence is, this is nth term. Right, the term of the sequence is this. Six, 2, 0, 2, 0, 2, 0, right? What is the nth term of the sequence, right? Okay. Yeah, this is very important. If I write here 2, 0, if I take Sn equal to 1 plus minus 1 over power n minus 1. Simply substitute n equal to 1. And what happened here? N equal to 1. 1 minus 1 equal to 0, minus 1 over power of 0, that equal to 1, 1 plus 1 equal to 0, that equal to, 1 plus 1 equal to 2, first term is 2, if I substitute n equal to, what happened, 1, minus 1 over power 2, minus 1 equal to 1, minus 1 over power 1 equal to minus 1, 1 minus 1 is equal to 0, if I substitute equal to 3, then 2, that means 2, 0, 2, 0, 2, 0, we will get from using this equal. Next two. If I take 1 minus 1, 1 minus 1, 1 minus 1. Right? Okay, first term is minus 1, second term is minus 1. For that, what I am taking here? Minus 1 over m plus 1. That means, so, if I substitute n equal to 1, what happened? Minus 1 over power of 1 plus 1. Minus 1 over power of 1 plus 1, nothing but. So, minus 1 over power of 1 plus 1, nothing but. We may take here plus plus 1 plus, that's why I am writing n plus 1. In place of n plus 1, you can write n minus 1 also, it is well. Okay. Minus 1 over power of n plus 1, that equal to n equal to 1, what happened? 1, n equal to 2 plus 1 equal 3, that equal to minus 1 over power of 3 equal to minus 1, 4, 1, minus 5, 1. Right, like this. So, if I write like this, my nth term is Sn equal to minus 1 over m plus 1. Here, I am taking 3, 15, so here I am taking 3, 13, 37, 81, like this. Okay, what is the nth term of sequence? Sn equal to n cube plus n square plus 1. Okay, this is very important. So that means if I take this, okay, what happened? 3, 30, n equal to 1, you can substitute here. If I substitute n equal to 1, 1 cube, nothing but 1, 1 square, nothing but 1, 3. So, first term is 3. If the substitution equal to 8 plus 4 plus 1, that equal to how much? 8 plus 5 equal to 13. N equal to 3, 37. N equal to 4, 81. You can substitute like this. We will get same answer. 5, Sn equal to 5, Sn equal to 5. So this is constant sequence of Sn equal to 5. So this is the nth term sequence is Sn that equal to 5. So range of sequence. So what is range of sequence? Already we know that. Sequence, right? Range of function, you know that. So for this is my n. Already I explained what is range domain, right? Oh, this is R, I'm taking real numbers. Okay, if I take X here, you will get some value. This value is Y. Okay. If I take X here, you will get X, right? So it's nothing but F of X. It's nothing but F of X, Y equal to F of X. So this is called an element. This is image of X, right? This is image of X. This is image of X. If I take Y here, this is YX is pre-image of X. Right? If I take Y, so this is pre-image of Y. So here I am taking that all these elements of N which are mapped to some elements of R. Which are mapped to some elements of R. So that means these element was mapped to which of elements of R. So that means this element is belonging to this set, right? So here this okay, you can take that this is domain, this is codomain, so this is range. Okay, this is range. So how to write here? This is I will like write here f of x such that x belong to n. This is range of function f here. F of x such that x belongs to n. So similarly, I want to define same thing in other way. My sequence is noted by Sn. Let Sn be a sequence from n to r, then the set Sn such that n belonging to r. Sn such that n belongs to n. So this set is called range of sequence Sn. Okay, so it is not a range of Sn only. So simply can write here range. So this is denoted by range of Sn only. So repeating I may again, let Sn be a sequence from n to r, then the set is called range of sequence Sn. It is denoted by range of Sn. So this range of sequence, let Sn be a sequence, then the set Sn such that n plus 3 is called range of sequence. Okay, it is denoted by range of Sn. Or simple anything you use here, range of Sn equal to this. Other thing, the set of all points of the sequence Sn is called range of sequence. Okay, simply you can say that the set of all points of the sequence Sn is called range of the sequence. Right? Therefore, the range of sequence Sn equal to Sn such that n belongs to n. Example, Sn is equal to n. I'm taking Sn equal to n. The range of Sn equal to what happen? Sn says that n belongs to n. S1, S2, Sn radius, right? That means by Sn equal to 1, 1, Sn equal to, S2 equal to 2, 3, 3, like this, okay? The range of Sn equal to n, here range of, right? Here I'm taking Sn equal to 1 by n. The range of Sn equal to Sn such that n belongs to n. Sn nothing but 1 by n such that n belongs to n. 1 by nothing but 1, 1 by 2, 1 by 3, 1 by 4. That means I want to substitute n belongs to n. Here n belongs to nothing but n equal to 1, 1, 2, 2, 2, 3, 1 by 5. This is range of Sn. If I take Sn equal to 1 by 2 n, range of Sn equal to 1 by 2 power such that n belongs to n. That equal to 1 by 2, 1 by 2 square, 1 by 2 cube divided by S. So this is range of Sn. Range of Sn, that equal to Sn is that n belongs to n. So S1, S2, S3 add S. S1 nothing but constant 3 to 4 pi. That means S1 is 3 to 4 pi, S2 3 to 4 pi, S3 3 pi. So range of Sn equal to 3 to 4 pi only. If I take this, Sn equal to minus 1 over power of n, range of Sn equal to minus 1 over power of n, such that n belongs to n. The range of Sn equal to minus 1 comma 1. So I think, example, Sn equal to minus 1 whole power of n square. So range of Sn equal to what happened? Minus 1 whole power of n square. N equal to 1, minus 1, 4, minus 6, 6. This is range of Sn. If I take Sn equal to n pi by 2, the range of Sn equal to Sn such that n plus 10, S1, S2, S3, S3. Here if I have n equal to S1 equal to 1, then 1, we can write n by pi by 2 equal to 1. 2 pi by the n pi equal to 0, that means 0. So n minus 1, minus 1. 1, 0, minus 1, 0. Like this we will get. That means the range of Sn equal to what we have here. 1, 0, minus 1. Substitute this here values n equal to 1, 2. This is easy because that. If I substitute n equal to 1, what happened? Pi by 2. N equal to 3, 2. That is sin pi equal to 0. N equal to 3, 3 pi by 2 nothing but minus 1. N equal to 4, 4 by nothing but 0. That means 1, 0, minus 1. 1, 0, minus 1, 0. It will come like this. That's why the range of Sn equal to this. If I take Sn equal to n by n plus 1, range of Sn equal to what happened? N into n plus 1, so that n plus n. So 2, 6, 12, 20, I think. Okay, bounded above sequence or upper bound of a sequence. Here we call the bounded sequence and upper bound of a sequence. Already we know that we have discussed bounded above set. Here I am going to discuss bounded above sequence. Okay, in place of Sn or S, what we get here only Sn. There we have taken that a set. Here I am taking Sn. So be careful. You can observe easily. So I am going to take here Sn is sequence and if there exists K1 belongs to R such that Sn less than or equal to K1 for all n belongs to n, then K1 is called upper bound of sequence Sn and Sn is called bounded above sequence. I am taking that let Sn be a sequence if there exists K1 belongs to R such that Sn less than or equal to K1 for all n belongs to n. Then K1 is called upper bound of sequence and Sn is called the sequence Sn is called bounded above sequence, right? K1 is called upper bound of sequence Sn and the sequence Sn is called bounded above sequence. Or you can define that a sequence Sn is said to be bounded above if the range of the sequence Sn is bounded above. The range of sequence is set to, already we discussed about set. The range of sequence is the set which is bounded above, then we say that the sequence Sn is bounded. Okay. So this other definition. A sequence Sn is said to be bounded above if the range of sequence Sn is bounded above. Example I'm taking. This is my sequence. Sn equal to 1 by n, S1 equal to what happened? 1, S2 equal to 1 by 2, S3 equal to 1 by 2. Sn is less than equal to 1 for all n belongs to n. Therefore 1 is an upper bound of Sn. That means 1 is all elements of sequence is less than equal to 1, that's why 1 is upper bound of the sequence then. Similarly, you can take that so for the range of I want to use here the range of the sequence. I say 1 by equal to 1, 1 by 2, 1 by 3 radius. We already discussed about this, right? So, which is the greater element here? I am taking that 1 is upper bound of this set, right? 1 is the maximum element of this set. Therefore, 1 is the upper bound of this range. Therefore, range of Sn is bounded above, therefore S1 is bounded above and Sn is bounded above. You can say that the range of S bounded above, therefore Sn is bounded above. Example, here 1 by 2 power n, Sn equal to 1 by 2 power of n. The range of Sn is equal to what happened here? Sn such that n belong into n. Sn such that n belong into n. So 1 by 2 nothing but 1 by 2, 1 by 4, 1 by 6. So equal to 1 by 2 is an upper. This is maximum. See, you can observe clearly 1 by 4, 1 by it is decreasing, that by this is maximum. Therefore, 1 by 2 is an upper bound of the sequence Sn. Therefore, 1, 2, 3, 4 also upper bound bounded. The range of Sn is bounded above. Example, minus 1 over 4 of n. Sn equal to minus 1 over 4 of n. The range of Sn is equal to minus 1 over 4 of n. So that n belongs to n. That equal to minus 1, comma 1. So 1, 2, 3 are upper bound of the, right, 1, sorry. And taking that, here minus 1, comma 1. Here upper bound of the sequence are, 1 is upper bound. You can take that 2, 3, 4 are also upper bound of the sequence. The range of equation is bounded above, therefore Sn is bounded above. I am taking here this range, range is upper bounded above, therefore I am taking that range is, Sn is also bounded above. If I take Sn equal to n by n plus 1, S1 equal to 1 by 2, S2 equal to 2 by 3, S2. Compare that all element are less than equal to 1 only, therefore 1 is upper bound of the sequence Sn. And one, not only 1, you get either 2, 3, 4 are also upper bound of the sequence Sn. Therefore, Sn is bounded above. If I take n, Sn equal to n, the range of Sn equal to what here? 1, 2, 3, there you go n. So, which is, what is the upper bound of the sequence? So, upper bound of range does not exist. Why? Because it is going to infinity. We are unable to restrict this set. That's why this set does not have any upper bound. Already we know that this is look like n. Natural number set is infinite set, does not have an upper bound. Therefore, the sequence also not bounded above. And the upper bound of the sequence does not exist. If I take that n power r, you can take n power r, n square, what n square, you can take that. Similarly to 1, 4, 9, 16 like this, that means so this sequence does not have upper bound, therefore it is not bounded above sequence, right? Because upper bound does not exist for this sequence. If I take n square plus 1 by n, Sn equal to this, that equal look like n plus 1 by n. So it is like 2, 5 by 2, 10 by 3, right? That means so here this term can go to infinite. This term is goes to decrease 0, but this term is goes to infinite. That means we are unable to restrict this set. There does not exist k1 such that Sn less than k1 for all inverse n. Therefore, Sn does not have an upper bound. Sn is not bounded above sequence. If I take Sn equal to n plus 1, n equal to n plus 1, that means this term goes to infinite. The range of sequence Sn is not bounded. Therefore, upper bound of the sequence does not exist, therefore range is not exist, upper bound of the range of sequence Sn does not exist. The range of Sn is not bounded above, Sn is not bounded above. Bounded below sequence or lower bound of a sequence. Let Sn be a sequence, if there exists K2 belongs to R such that Sn is there equal to K2 for all n belongs to n, then K2 is called lower bound of sequence Sn, and Sn and the sequence Sn is called whatever K2 is called to lower bound sequence Sn, and the sequence Sn is called bounded below sequence. Okay, I'm repeating again. Let Sn be a sequence. So if there exists K2 belongs to R such that K2 such that what I'm taking here for all there is K2 belongs to R such that Sn is equal to K2 for all n belongs to n, then K2 is called lower bound of sequence Sn, and the sequence Sn is called bounded below sequence. Or I can define other way also, a sequence Sn is said to be bounded below sequence if the range of sequence Sn is bounded below. So the example is Sn equal to 1 by n, Sn equal to 1 by n, I am taking that S1 equal to 1, S2 equal to 2, S3 equal to 3. 0 less than Sn for all n belongs to n. So here I am taking that minus 1 comma 2 comma minus 2 comma, that means all of this term goes to 0 only. This 0 is upper lower bound of the sequence Sn, and not only 0, you can take that minus 1 minus 2 minus 3 also as the lower bound of the sequence Sn. The range of Sn, you can take it other way also. The range of Sn equal to what happened? 1 by s is that n belongs to n. You can substitute 1 by 1 by 2, 1 by 3. That means so which is the greater element, you can take 1, right? Lower element is we'll get this all if we observe this is the element goes to 0. That means 0 is lower bound of the range. Not only 0, you can take this are the lower bound of the range. Therefore, the range of Sn is bounded below. Sn is also bounded below sequence. If I take Sn, the range of Sn equal to what happens? N such that n belongs to n. 1, 2, 3. So 1, 0, minus 1, minus 2 are the lower bound of the range of the sequence n. So see, it is look like n, right? Natural number, it does not have upper bound, but if you have lower bound, we easily say that this is lowest element. So that's why all elements of this range of sequence which is greater than equal to 1. So 1 is lower bound. Not only 1, you can take that 0, minus 1, minus 2, all you can take that to minus 1 by 2, minus 1 by 3, minus 1 are the lower bound of the sequence Sn. The range of Sn is bounded below. Sn is also bounded below. If I take minus 1 over n, the range of Sn equal to other minus 1, 1. Here, minus 1, 0, minus 2 are the lower bound of the range Sn. Therefore, Sn is bounded below sequence. You can take that minus 1. So then what happens? The range of Sn equal to minus 1, that is minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. That means, so it goes to minus infinite. That means unable to find lower bound for this sequence. That means, so the sequence does not have lower bound. That means lower bound does not exist for this sequence. Therefore, Sn does not bounded below sequence. We take 1 minus whole square, 1 n square by n. So Sn equal to this. 1 by n minus n. So Sn equal to 0, S2 equal to 3 minus 5 by 0, S3 equal to minus 8 by 3. So that means this element goes to minus infinite. We are unable to find any lower bound for this sequence, right? This sequence not bounded below sequence. If I take that n by n plus 1, that means all terms are goes to 0. Here 1 by 2 is determinant, that means all other terms goes to. Goes to 1 only, right? 3 by 4 can also 3.75 or like this. So that means 1 by 2, 0, minus 1 are the lower bound. So you see, this is lowest element 1 by 2. Therefore, 1 by 2 is lower bound of the sequence. So you can take that 0, minus 1 are the also lower bound of this sequence. Therefore, Sn is bounded below sequence. You can take that n in place 1. Why? Because this term of sequence is 2, 6, 12. 2, 6, 12. That means the lower bound of the sequence is 2. But upper bound does not exist for this sequence. Lower bound of the range of sequence Sn. Exist, the range of the sequence Sn is bounded below and Sn is bounded below sequence, right? Bounded sequence. Let Sn be a sequence if they exist to k1 comma k2 belongs to R such that k1, k2 less than equal to Sn less than equal to k1 for all n belongs to n, then Sn is called bounded sequence. Or a sequence Sn is said to be bounded sequence if the range of sequence is bounded. A sequence Sn is said to be bounded sequence if the range of sequence bounded. Other thing is, a sequence Sn is said to be bounded sequence if there exists to k belongs to R such that mod Sn less than equal to k for all n belongs to n. So example is 1 by n. You can say that Sn equal to 1 by n. This has lower bound, upper bound. This Sn is bounded. Already we discussed that lower bound, upper bound. This term of sequence lies between 0 and 1. Therefore, Sn is bounded sequence. If I take minus 1 power fn. So Sn equal to minus 1 over power of n, that means minus 1 less than equal to minus 1 over power of n less than equal to 1. So this is also bounded sequence. So supremum of a sequence or least upper bound of a sequence. Let Sn be a sequence and u be the upper bound of sequence Sn if any real number less than u is not upper bound of Sn, then u is called least upper bound of Sn and Sn is supremum of sequence. That is called supremum sequence Sn. Okay, I am taking that. Let Sn be a sequence and u be an upper bound of Sn. U be an upper bound of Sn. Any real number less than u is not upper bound of sequence Sn, then u is called least upper bound of a sequence Sn. Right? Simply, already I explained in the last class about the least upper bound and supremum of the set. In place of set, I am taking Sn. You can clearly I explained there. By using that, I am writing here. Sn is a sequence and u be upper bound of sequence. If any real number less than u is not upper bound of Sn, then is called least upper bound of sequence Sn or supremum of sequence Sn. It is denoted by super Sn or super Sn or LUB of Sn. Super Sn or super Sn or LUB of Sn. And this is notation. Sn equal to, I am reading 1 by n, 1 by 2, 1 by 3, Sn equal to 1 by n, the range of Sn equal to this, right, this supreme, the upper bound of equal to 1 by n. Okay, so out of the upper bounds, which is least to, but problem we have to take that upper bound, if we have to find upper bounds. So if least upper bound is called least upper bound of the sequence, right? These are the upper bound of the sequence. Least upper bound of Sn is 1, therefore supremum of Sn equal to 1 by n. If put Sn equal to 1 by 5 n, and range of Sn equal to this, 1 by 5 or like this, you can observe that all term goes to 0. Upper bound of suffix is 1 by 5, 1 by 4, 1 by 3, add as s, right? LUB of Sn equal to 1 by 5, so Sn equal to 1 by 5. If you take Sn equal to minus 1 over 4 of n, so Sn equal to minus 1 over 4 of n, range of Sn equal to what happened, minus 1 over 4 of n, so is that n belonging to n. So range is 1, upper bound of the sequence is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, which is least, 1 is least, therefore super Sn equal to 1. Similarly, you can take that Sn equal to n by n plus 1, that means, so if I write set, the range of the set is this, what is the upper bound, least upper bounds of this set is, or here goes to, that means all term goes to 1, that means 1, 2, 3, 4 upper bound, out of that which is least, 1 is least, therefore super Sn equal to 1, and or 1 is called least upper bound. If I take n equal to n plus 1 by that, it is in the form n plus 1 by n. Okay, it is not like that. Here I am not writing this. So 1 plus n by that. Thereby you can write this is n square. It is missing something else. N square, that means n plus 1 by n. So this, okay. Not like that. Okay, n plus 1 only here, I may set. N plus 1 here, 1 plus 1 by n. 1 plus 1 by n. That equal to Sn equal to what happened? Range of Sn equal to 2, 3, 4, 5, right? Now all our terms are goes to, this is goes to 1, this is goes to 2, that means, sorry, this is 2. Upper bound of this 2, 2, 3, 4 are, list is 2, therefore super Sn equal to 2. Okay, you can take that Sn equal to n, the range of Sn, the upper bound does not exist, supreme also not exist. You can 3 to 4, constant sequence, super of Sn equal to 3 to 4, pi. If I take this sequence, you can find Sn equal to 2, 4, and 2, and n, that equal to, the term of the sequence is 1, which is all terms goes to 1, therefore super Sn equal to 1. Pi power n, that equal to pi power, that this sequence does not exist supreme. Why? Because this term goes to infinite, that's why it supreme not exist. Let Sn be a sequence, epsilon raise 0, and U supreme of Sn, then U minus epsilon is not upper bound of sequence Sn. That means you can observe here, let Sn be a sequence, epsilon greater than 0, and U is supreme of Sn, then U minus epsilon is not upper bound of Sn. Why? Because it is supremum. If I remove from element from U, that means it not become supremum. So it is not become upper bound. That's why U minus epsilon is not upper bound of sequence Sn. But equal to 1 by, I am taking that epsilon equal to 0.001. Supremum epsilon equal to 1. I already know that. Epsilon equal to, I take that 10. U minus epsilon equal to 1 minus 0.001. So this is not upper bound. Why? Because 1 is there. Or you can get other element, so 0.99 element also you will get that. So that element is bigger than this element, that's why, so this is not upper bound. Okay, Sn comma Tn are two subsequences, then super Sn plus Tn equal to super Sn plus sub Tn. If I take that, Sn comma Tn are two sequence, then super Sn plus Tn equal to super Sn plus sub Tn. If I 1 plus 1 by, sub 1 plus 1 by, sub 1 equal to 1 and sub 1 by equal to 1. So, sub 1 plus 1 by n equal to sub 1 plus sub 2, that equal to this. Sn equal to minus 1 over Tn equal to 1 by 2 n, sub Sn equal to 1, sub Tn equal to 1 by 2, then sub Sn plus Tn equal to what happened? C by 2. Infimum of sequence or greatest lower bound of a sequence. Let I am taking that Sn be a sequence and V be a lower bound of Sn. If any real number greater than V is not lower bound of Sn, then V is called greatest lower bound of sequence Sn or infimum of sequence Sn. It is denoted by inf Sn or inf Sn or GLB, greatest lower bound of Sn. So that means you can already discuss about the infimum also in set. So I am taking the Sn be sequence and take smallest value V is the lower bound of sequence. If any real number greater than V is not lower bound of sequence Sn, then V is called greatest lower bound of sequence Sn. So it is denoted by inf Sn and inf Sn or GLB of Sn. I am taking example 1 by n. Sn equal to 1 by n. Range of Sn equal to what happened here? 1 by n such that n belongs to n. Which is nothing but 1, 1 by 2, 1 by 3, divided as like this. What is lower bound of this set? 0 minus 1, right? Which is out of lower bound, which is greater lower bound? 0 is greatest lower bound. Therefore, here 0 is called NP1 of SN. You can take 1 by 3 n. Range of SN equal to this 1 by 3, 1 by n, right? Okay, 0 is the lower bound. Not only 0, you can take minus 0, minus 1, and minus 1, 2 are the lower bound of this set. Out of this lower bound, which is greater, 0 is greater. Therefore, G is 0 is called greatest lower bound of SN. Therefore, NP SN equal to 0. So, minus 1 power of n. SN equal to minus 1 power of n. Range of SN equal to what of n here? Minus 1 power S is that n belongs to n. So, range is this is, right? Which is infimum minus 1. You can write that S n equal to n, right? Range is equal to 1. Range of S n equal to what of n here? 1. This is the natural number set, right? So, minus 17 to 29. What is the range? It goes to like this, where we are unable to find right? Any least value. That's why infimum of S n not exist. If I take only place, it is infimum is 17 to 29. But it is negative, that means negative number goes to minus infinite. We are unable to find infimum for this set. If I take minus 1 over, that means same as this. Infimum does not exist for this set also. Infimum of 3 to 4 y equal to 3 to 4 5. Why? Because the sequence is constant that equal 1. Let SN be sequence epsilon greater than 0. If V is infimum of sequence SN, then V plus epsilon is not lower bound of SN. So, note I am writing here. Let SN be sequence epsilon is greater than 0 and V is infimum of SN, then V plus epsilon is not lower bound of SN. You can take that, let epsilon is greater than 0 and V is infimum. Infimum nothing but it is out of all greatest lower bound, V is least lower bound, right? Greatest lower bound. Out of all lower bound, V is greatest lower bound. That means V is infimum. If I add any number to that, it becomes not lower bound of SN. For example, I will take that infimum SN equal to 1, this is 1. Epsilon equal to 0.01. That means V plus epsilon equal to what happened? 1.01. But 1 pi epsilon is not lower bound of Y because 1 is lower bound. That means, so if I add any epsilon small quantity, that means not to become a lower bound of Sn. Let Sn comma Tn are two sequences, then infimum Sn plus Tn equal to infimum Sn plus infimum Tn. So, example, I am 3 to 4 pi plus minus 1 4. What is infimum of Sn equal to 3 to 4 pi? Infimum Tn equal to minus 1. So, therefore, if I add both things, infimum of this equal to what happened? 3 to 4, 4. Infimum of Sn plus Tn equal to infimum of Sn plus Tn. Yeah. Infimum of Sn equal to minus Sta, that equal to infimum of Sn minus infimum of Sn. Infimum of Sn minus Tn is that equal to infimum of Sn minus infimum of Tn. Here you can take that minus 3 to 4 pi. So, minus minus nothing but 3 to 4 pi 6, right? Infimum of this thing equal to this. Infimum of 3 to 4 pi minus n whole power n plus 3 to 4 pi. Otherwise, you can take that 3 to 4 6, 3 to 4 4, 3 to 4 6, 3 to 4 5, like this element. So, this is will become supremum, right? Infimum of this sequence is 3 to 4, 4, 4, right? Infimum of this sequence is 3 to 4, 4, which is less than equal to infimum of Sn minus infimum of Sn. Infimum of Sn equal to 3 to 4, 6. Infimum of Sn plus Tn equal minus Tn equal to 3 to 4, 4. Infimum of Sn plus Tn equal to 3 to 4, 6, right? Therefore, infimum of Sn plus Tn is then equal to, again, I am writing here, supremum of Sn minus Tn is greater than equal to sup Sn minus sup Tn. And Sn equal to 1, Tn equal to minus 1 power n, sup Sn equal to 1, infimum is equal to T. So that means, Sn minus Tn equal to what happened? 1 plus minus 1 power, that equal to 0 to 0, 0. Sup Sn minus Tn equal to 2. Sup Sn minus Tn equal to 0. And sup Sn equal to 1 and sup Tn equal to 1, that means 1 minus 0. Therefore, sup Sn minus Tn is greater than equal to sup Sn minus sup Tn. Infimum Sn equal to 1, infimum Tn equal to minus 1, Sn minus Tn equal to 2, 0, 0. Infimum of Sn equal to 0, therefore infimum Sn minus infimum Tn equal to 1 minus 1 equal to 2. Therefore, infimum Sn is less than equal to infimum Sn minus Tn, right? So, this is the end of lecture 10 on sequence. So, today we have discussed about the all slides of what is sequence, the range of sequence, boundedness of sequence. We have discussed some problems also we solved, right? So thank you for watching this okay. This is the lecture.